So this is a recipe for Florentines. It's something that my dad would buy when we were little at Christmas. I've changed the recipe a little bit to use cranberries, dates and pistachios, some things that are in abundance at this time of the year.
Place the butter, sugar and the honey into a saucepan. Weigh 75 grams of plain flour and set to one side.
So next, I need to chop up the dates and the pistachios. When I was little, I didn't really like dates because I thought they looked like cockroaches. Something not very nice, I know, but now, huge convert, huge fan. I'm just chopping the pistachios quite finely because you don't really want a whole pistachio in your mouth when you're biting into these. Here we go.
Add the flour, cranberries, flaked almonds, chopped pistachios, and finally, the dates.
So give this a good mix. That's nice and stiff now. Remember, you're going to be spooning teaspoons of it onto the tray, and then when it goes into the oven, it'll melt and go flat. Remember, you only need a teaspoonful. Don't be tempted to put more on because it will just create one massive Florentine. I love the fact that there's pistachios and cranberries in these. They almost look jewel-like, glistening under the sugar.
And there we go. They're ready to go into the oven at 180 degrees Celsius. They only need 8 to 10 minutes. Until they turn a golden brown colour. Once they've cooled completely, you can decorate them. This time, I'm using melted white and milk chocolate. Lush.
I find that just brushing the chocolate on just makes it a little bit less messy. This looks like it's almost ready now for me to make the traditional zigzag marks in the bottom. So just take a fork and just carefully zigzag down the chocolate.
Once the chocolate has completely set, you can package them to make a very pretty Christmas present for somebody.
I'm really pleased with how these have turned out. They've gone nice and thin. You can see all the ingredients, the cranberries, the pistachios. Lush.